Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back for another video. Today, we're going to be attempting to build a gaming PC from Wish.com that is able to run all of today's modern games, such as Fortnite and Call of Duty. We are aiming to run medium to high settings on every game we throw at it. And since Fortnite is the primary game we are currently playing, I'm looking to get at least 100 to 144 FPS on competitive settings, all for around a $300 price tag. If you're new to our channel, we mainly focus on budget gaming PC builds, using parts from sites like eBay, as eBay, in my opinion, offers the best bang for your buck in the budget gaming PC market. But for this build, I wanted to challenge myself a bit. If you do a quick YouTube search for Wish.com gaming computers or Wish.com graphics cards, it will result in nothing but negative feedback. This is due to the fact that there is a tremendous amount of fake and or counterfeit graphics cards up for sale on Wish. And to the unexperienced, uneducated consumer, you could be tricked into buying one of these graphics cards. This has resulted in Wish.com having an awful reputation when it comes to gaming PC parts. And that's a shame, because Wish.com has some amazing deals on electronics and is why it has gained so much popularity in the first place. The reason Wish can offer such good prices is because they are based out of China, but on that same note, this is why they have such a large counterfeiting problem. Wish.com, being based out of China, is where I got the idea for this video. After doing some research, I found out that basically every single fake graphics card being sold on Wish was either an NVIDIA GTX 1050 or a 1060, so I knew to steer clear of these cards. Continuing down the rabbit hole, since Wish is a Chinese retailer, they sell many Chinese brands. When I say Chinese brands, I don't mean things that say made in China. I mean companies actually based out of China. As we all know, 9 times out of 10, stuff made in China costs less for us as a consumer, so I wanted to find actual Chinese branded graphics cards, assuming they would cost less than the US branded graphics cards. After a brief Google search, I discovered the two most popular graphics card brands based out of China were called Yestin and Pradeon. These are real, respected Chinese name brand companies, and these cards can be bought for very good prices. I eventually found a great deal on a brand new Pradeon RX 560 for around $80 on Wish, which is currently selling for around $130 here in the States. What I also quickly learned about Wish.com is you can usually get really good deals on things like LED fans, LED strips, custom PC cases, off-brand power supplies, and gaming PC accessories such as mechanical keyboards, gaming mouses, headsets, and so on. But when it came to the main core components of the PC, such as the motherboard, the CPU, storage, RAM, I found Wish to be more expensive than sites like eBay. I'm going to guess this is to cover the cost of shipping and import fees, as many of the items sold on Wish offer very cheap or free shipping. Another thing I found with these core PC components is they were either used, old, or used and old. This didn't scare me away though, as I love building computers that can handle modern games with older tech, hence my channel name, Tech Yesterday. So for the sake of this video, I purchased the very best price to performance parts I could find. As these parts were shipping from China, they took about 2 to 3 weeks to arrive. Once everything arrived, I went through each package to validate I received everything I ordered and to make sure everything worked. As previously stated, for the graphics card, we went with a Chinese branded AMD card called Pradeon, not to be confused with Radeon. After inspecting and disassembling the Pradeon RX 560, I was pleased to find out it was using an authentic AMD chip, so off to a good start. When deciding what motherboard to go with, I first had to see what the best CPU I could get on Wish was. To my surprise, I was able to get an Intel i5-2400, which if you have seen any of my other budget gaming PC videos, you'll know that this CPU is a budget powerhouse. The downside to this though, is this chip was $60 on Wish. Now that I had my CPU, I needed a motherboard that could fit this chip. I found a great deal on a Gigabyte gaming board for just under $40. This motherboard was compatible with my CPU, and supported DDR3 RAM. Both of these components were in used condition though, and another thing to consider, when buying these older motherboards, they do not support USB 3.0, but this is easily remedied by buying a USB 3.0 hub for around $10. For the hard drive, we found a new 500GB drive for $25 and 12GB of DDR3 RAM for around $35. On top of the 500GB hard drive, I wanted to add an SSD. Just like the graphics card, you can easily be tricked into buying counterfeit Samsung or SanDisk SSD drives on Wish.com. So again, I wanted to go with a Chinese branded SSD. After some research, we discovered the reputable brand Vasekey. We bought a 128GB Vasekey SSD for around $25. I bought the best gaming case I could find on Wish that had real tempered glass front and side panels and not some cheap plastic. This case also has the ability to add up to 9 LED fans, which usually only the premium gaming cases offer. This case ran about $80, but you can buy other cheaper cases on Wish for around $40 to $50. For the RGB lighting, we got a 5-pack of programmable LED fans for $40 and an LED strip kit for $10. They were both the Cool Moon brand. Cool Moon seems like a very popular brand in the Chinese RGB LED market, and they are very, very good quality for the price. Last but not least, we went with a no-name 500-watt power supply for about $30. Adding all of this up, you're probably saying to yourself, "Wait a minute, Mr. Tech Yesterday, this is more than $300, and you would be correct, but don't click off the video just yet. At the end of the video, I will show you exactly how I got everything I just listed for just about $300. I'm no clickbaiter like those Paul boys. I love you, KSI. I didn't want to stop with the PC itself. I wanted to test out Wish to see what kind of quality gaming accessories I could get at a good price. And this is where I think Wish really shines. I was able to get a Blue Switch mechanical gaming keyboard for $35. This keyboard came with actual Blue Switches that feel amazing. Blue Switches, in my opinion, are the best type of switches as they are super tactile and super clicky. This keyboard feels almost identical to my $100 SteelSeries keyboard. For the gaming mouse, we chose a cheap $10 one that came with two side buttons and again was loaded with LED lights. It has 5 selectable DPI modes and is very responsive in-game. So far, I have 0 complaints. So, what everyone wants to know, how does the PC perform? Well, to say the least, I was pleasantly surprised. We were easily able to hit our goal of 100 to 144 FPS on Fortnite at competitive settings. The PC is able to run every modern game we threw at it at about 60 to 100 FPS on medium settings, even being able to handle certain titles on high settings. We put this PC through intense testing. It was easily able to handle modern esports titles like Call of Duty, Apex Legends, and PUBG. We also made sure to throw some graphically intensive games at it like Gears of War 5, The Outer Worlds, and Wolfenstein. This PC was able to handle every single one of them. So for a gamer on a budget, or for someone who really loves the Wish.com website, this PC is definitely an option for you. I built this PC to prove a point that even with all the negative press other YouTubers give the Wish.com website, a decent gaming computer can be built. While I don't 100% recommend buying a gaming PC from Wish.com, if you are in the market for a gaming PC, I would recommend this build over a $600 to $800 pre-built from places like Best Buy any day. This build can give you almost identical performance for half the price. So, how do you purchase this build for only $300? The answer is simple, using eBay. As much as I've tried liking Wish, it can't compete with eBay. Almost every PC part sold on Wish can be bought on eBay for a better price. I've put eBay links for every part we used in this build in the video description below. If you are truly considering building this PC for yourself, please do yourself a favor and watch some of my other budget PC builds on this channel, such as the $250 Console Killer build, which will give you even better performance than this Wish build for less money. If this video gets 1500 likes, I will do you a complete step-by-step build guide for this Wish.com PC. I will even compare it to an eBay build for the same price to see how much performance $300 can really get you. So hit that like button. As always, I want to thank you guys for all the support. I read each and every one of your comments, and your continued loyalty motivates me to keep making YouTube videos and coming up with creative ideas. So make sure to drop a like on this video and subscribe if you're new. I'll see you guys in the next video. Later, you butts.